Today, most of the statistics quoted about Nigeria are developed abroad and bear little relation to the facts on the ground.
Such statistics by the World Bank, IMF and other foreign bodies described as wild estimates President Buhari said cannot work for Nigeria. The president maintains that it is high time the country moved forward with homegrown solutions.
I therefore look forward to receiving your baseline study, as this will help us shape ideas for a sustainable and prosperous future. Rest assured that all key MDAs will be available to meet and discuss how we can collectively build a new Nigeria that caters for all. Now, no one person or a group of persons has a monopoly of knowledge or wisdom or patriotism. In the circumstances, you may feel free to co-opt, consult, and defer for any knowledgeable person if, in your opinion, such a move enriches your deliberations and adds to the quality of your decisions.
The president said, although Nigeria has exited recession, the reported growth rate is still not fast enough to create the needed jobs to meet national ambition of collective prosperity, while thanking members of the Economic Advisory Council for their patriotism and commitment to Nigeria. President Buhari reminds them of his administration's commitment to lifting 100 million people out of poverty in 10 years. The council, he said, is required to come out with far-reaching measures towards achieving the objectives as well as moving the country and the economy forward.
Many of the ideas we developed in the last 4 years were targeted at taking Nigeria back to the path of growth. I am sure, as you are aware, as a government, we prioritize agriculture as a critical sector to create jobs and bring prosperity to our rural communities. Our programs covered the entire agricultural value chain, from seed to fertilizer to grains and ultimately our dishes. You can clearly see the impact. However, the absence of reliable data is hindering our ability to upgrade these programs and assure their sustainability.
The federal government, he admits, is also struggling to measure the impact of its social investment programs.
Today, we hear international organizations claiming to spend hundreds of millions of dollars on IDPs in the Northeast. But when you visit the camps, you rarely see the impact. Last week, I directed the new Minister for Humanitarian Affairs to commence a comprehensive data-gathering exercise in our IDP camps in the Northeast.
Actionable data, President Buhari said, is critical towards implementing effective strategies in addressing the nation's humanitarian issues and other pressing problems. Chairman of the Council, Professor Doyin Salami, assured President Buhari that their mandate is all about Nigeria and Nigerians, not as numbers, but as people. He pledged members' commitment towards ensuring that the economy grows in a manner that is rapid, inclusive, sustained, and sustainable so that Nigerians will feel the impact.